Hello everybody and welcome to another channel update video. So in this update I want to briefly talk about the fact that I have a new microphone. And just as what happened with the past microphone upgrade, it's probably going to take a few weeks before I get fully used to it and before I can finally find a good mix between microphone audio and all that kind of stuff. So right now, just note, it might be too loud, I might be too quiet, I don't know how this will affect games, I need to find a nice balance there, among other things. Now, I don't know really how different I sound, I haven't listened to any footage, if you will, any audio of the new microphone, but it's supposed to be quite the step up from what I had. So what I have been using, all the way back, pretty much from the inception of my channel, I used to use Turtle Beach headsets for my microphone. And I just used the built-in microphone all the way up until 2018. I was using Turtle Beach microphones. Then, of course, in I think mid-2018, I had to get a new headset because they weren't selling PX22s anymore. And I ended up getting a Logitech G430 headset, and I used the built-in mic, and it was the worst thing anybody had ever heard. So I decided to look into an actual desktop microphone that I had never had before, and a very affordable one was the first iteration of the Blue Snowball, which is very great in quality. It's very easy to use, and a lot of people immediately pointed out that I sounded 100 million times better than I ever had before. And I've used a Blue Snowball all the way up until just, well, today. I don't know if you guys can hear a quality difference. I don't know if I sound better or if I sound good or anything. Like I said, I don't have all of the settings set up yet for the microphone. Just know that I also do not have any form of pop filter for this microphone right now. So I don't know how the noises are in the microphone yet. Anyways, my Blue Snowball is sitting over there on the bed. And it is still fully functional, so if anything ever happens to this, I can use that as a fallback, as a backup. However, this is the Blue Yeti 10, which is supposed to be studio quality. Now, I did not buy this. This was actually a Christmas gift. And for those of you that might be wondering, why are you only just now getting a Christmas gift? Without going into too much detail, my family was unable to celebrate Christmas last year. And so we had postponed it until, well, about a weekend ago. And this was pretty much one of the things that that I received. Completely unexpected. And now I decided, after talking with a few different people, that it would make a lot of sense. Because see, what I was going to do is I was going to continue using the Snowball until that broke. Then I would use this. But then people were saying, well, it would also make just as much, if not more, sense to use your new microphone and then use the old one as a fallback if anything happens to this one. So that's what I've done. Now, I did run a couple tests with the microphone. I don't have the software installed yet where I can edit the LED lights and stuff on it, and I can edit the sounds and all that kind of stuff on the microphone. None of that stuff is installed right now, but I had listened to a short, like, 2-second clip of just background noise, because I wanted to see if this picked up on a lot of white noise and background noise. I don't know how well it does pick up on that, but one thing I noticed was, and I don't know if you guys can hear it, maybe if I be quiet, listen real closely, you might be able to hear it. Then again, maybe not. See, the microphone, this one in particular, actually has a little LED circle thing on it that shows me how much microphone gain it's receiving right now, how much it's picking up on my voice. So when I talk, I can actually see how loud I'm talking into the microphone. Never had something like that before. Previously, I had to use my headset here, my G430s, have the microphone on, but have my recording software recording the Snowball, and then I could talk into the microphone, just like I'm doing right now, on the headset so that I can tell if I'm being too quiet or too loud. Now I can literally just see. Like, for example, I'm in the yellow right now, which probably means I'm pretty loud. Regardless, though, the one background noise thing that this thing constantly picks up on is this very, very reverberating, grinding vibration sound. And that's actually because my computer now sits on my desk. The actual computer sits on the desk now. That's a story for another time. And when it's running, the desk vibrates. It's not a vibration that I can feel just through touch, but it's a vibration the microphone can pick up on. Now, I seem to have at least mostly solved that issue by, the microphone sits up high enough with its own built-in stand. See, the Snowball has a tripod that you can hook into it, but it is super small and very low down. So I always had to use an old Hot Wheel car box, and I'd sit that on the desk and then set the Snowball on that, and that's how it was actually lined up with my mouth. I don't have to do that for this, but in the box, the packaging that the Yeti came with, there is a small strip of styrofoam stuff that obviously is to keep it nice and packaged in there. Well, I pulled that out, and now I have this sitting on that. I have the Yeti sitting on the actual piece of styrofoam, and it seems to have alleviated most of that vibration noise. Hopefully. You guys can obviously tell me how bad it sounds if it doesn't sound very good, because I don't know. Now, there's a lot that I still have to learn about this, because like I said, there's a whole software that can come with it and that can help you change things from audio, how it sounds, how sensitive you want it to be, etc. So what you're hearing right now is basically, I guess you could say, factory settings is kind of how you would refer to it. Now, I can definitely already tell you that I know that simply moving stuff on the desk is very loud on the microphone. It was for the Snowball as well. For example, if I pick up my water and drink and then put it down, that probably made a really loud thump noise to you, even though to me, it didn't really do anything. That's always been a problem with the Snowball for me. I've always made that noise without realizing it. Sometimes it affects people, sometimes it doesn't. I don't know. Really depends on the game in question. Now, here's some other functions that this microphone has that I did not have on the Snowball. First of all, I have a built-in mute button. Yes, the first iteration of the Snowball does not get a mute, which means I could never mute myself when recording. So, for example, I'm going to talk right now, and then I'm just going to go ahead and mute myself while I'm talking. And then I can unmute it, and here we are again. Didn't have that ability on the Snowball, which meant if I was recording and I needed to eat something or I wanted to snack on something while I was like watching an anime, I couldn't, because, well, obviously it would be way too loud on the microphone. Now I can, you know. Another thing is I don't use Discord overlay in 99% of the games I play for various reasons. So I can't utilize a lot of the Discord features like the automatic mute function where you can keybind it and mute your Discord chat or whatever you're in, mute you on Discord by simply pressing keys. Never has worked for me. So now I can actually mute myself without having to go all the way out and manually mute it on Discord itself. Again, making it easy if I'm watching anime with somebody or if I'm playing a game with somebody, I can now do that whether I want to eat or whether I want to move around on the desk without causing too much noise. Fucking awesome. I also can change how much gain I want the microphone to have right here. For example, I can turn it up or turn it down. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to leave it as is. And I'll get quieter and or get louder. I don't really know. I'm probably not going to mess with that too much unless somebody specifically tells me that, you're too quiet or something in Discord, and then I can turn it up. Okay, I got my phone vibrated. Here's another thing. There is an optional setting on the back of the microphone, which will actually change the position of the microphone, which is fucking awesome. Again, the Snowball doesn't have this. The Snowball, the second iteration of the Snowball does have this, the upgraded version. I didn't have the upgraded version. The upgraded version also had a mute button. Mine didn't because I didn't have the upgraded version. So basically what the position does is it will determine what directions the microphone will pick up on. Right now it's a cone. Basically, it's pointing at me. It can only pick up on sounds from me, meaning it can still, of course, pick up on sounds bouncing around the room. But if I move my hands to the back of the microphone, just like when I was testing in a Discord chat, the person there couldn't hear me typing on my keyboard, which has always been an issue with the Snowball. Whenever I touched the keyboard, it sounded like I was slamming down on a piece of plastic. They couldn't even hear a single key unless I specifically tried to make it loud. Now, you guys probably can hear it since it's picking up on everything, but I'm gonna hope. So there you go. I just used the keyboard, and I'm gonna hope that if you hear it, it's very, very quiet. That's awesome. Same goes with clicking and mouse scrolling. Now, of course, other positions, I can select it to pick up 360 degrees around the microphone, which, of course, would absolutely pick up on the keyboard and stuff, most likely. I can have it a two-way if I'm doing, like, an interview with somebody and I have them sitting on the other side. It's definitely a huge step up to any piece of hardware I've ever used, from headset microphones to even the Snowball. And that was already a step up in quality. I had never had something with that kind of quality. So yeah, the only thing with the microphone's software is I'm very scared at actually downloading the software. Now, I know it's just supposed to edit my microphone settings, but the Logitech G430s are still factory for me. I do not have the Logitech G430 software. You pretty much have to have the G430 software in order to make them not garbage as a headset. I have never used them since all the way back when I first got the headset in mid-2018. Why? Because the software doesn't just edit how you hear in your headphones, it actually edits your PC's sound audio, not just the headphone audio. And it doesn't just edit it to where I can hear differently, it actually edits it, period. It changes the actual PC software. And when I record something, after having used the software to edit my headset, that recording will actually pick up on those sound changes, not just for me. It should be only my ears that hear something different. You guys shouldn't be hearing something different. Well, it didn't do that. So I have, ever since then, been very afraid and skeptical of downloading this kind of software for this kind of different pieces of devices and stuff. So I'm a little worried that if I download that here, and you might ask, how did you fix it? Because uninstalling that software didn't fix it. The only way I fixed the changes that were made with the Logitech software was by simply getting a new hard drive, which I was going to do anyways. And once I got the new hard drive, I never even once thought about installing that software. If it fucks things up, I'm going to be very, very upset if I go to download this. But I would love to customize things. There's various other things that features that it comes with. And of course, you can, like I said, change the LED colors and stuff. Right now it's green and yellow and red, which is your usual, but I would like it to be blue because I want everything to be blue. So yeah. Anyways, guys, that's the end of this. The air conditioner is not on right now. It does pick up on the air conditioner, of course, but that's any microphone that I have is going to pick up on that. It's only like 3 feet away. And I'll go ahead and cut the video off here. And hopefully it's not too bad, but I'll go ahead and upload it and you guys can tell me how the quality sounds as is right now. Does something need to be changed? Is it too loud? Is it too quiet? Is it something just doesn't sound right, or I don't know. That's what you guys can let me know of. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next channel update video.